front of the 84mm Carl Gustav, and it's easy to see why. The weapon is quite practical for dismounted infantry, especially at long ranges, and creates a thrilling blast, so it's fun to shoot. The US Army had a handful in service with special operations units, and they proved so popular that the Army began distributing them widely. Not bad for a weapon with its first design dating back 70 years. Of course, a lot has changed in 7 decades. The Army is even testing a new version of the Carl Gustav called the M4, known in the United States as the M3E1. To put it simply, it's a really powerful rifle that vents pressure from the blast, which propels the round from a port in the launcher's rear. It would be absolutely unwise to stand behind a Carl Gustav when one goes off. It's not a rocket launcher, exactly. But the Carl Gustav can fire rounds which have a tiny rocket to boost them farther. A wide variety of ammunition ranges from high explosives, anti-tank warheads, smoke and eviscerating flechette darts. The war in Afghanistan had a lot to do with the Carl Gustav seeing a revival in US service. Militants harassed American troops from long ranges and from behind cover, making it hard to shoot back. A missile from an orbiting aircraft or a shoulder-fired javelin launcher would reach far enough, at a cost of around $80,000 per missile. A single Carl Gustav round costs at most around 3% as much, and carries an effective range of 1,000 meters if it's a rocket-boosted round. So it's no wonder why the Army loves it. Fundamentally, the launcher's design hasn't changed. Saab, the weapon's Swedish developer, is pitching the M3E1 as a collection of evolutionary improvements optimized for urban warfare. It's slightly smaller and weighs around 15 pounds, 7 pounds lighter than the current M3. The M3's weight is one thing soldiers don't tend to like about it. And since modern soldiers wear a lot more headgear, Saab tweaked the design to be more ergonomic and adjustable. Awkward is not a feeling a soldier wants to have when firing a high explosive round in an urban firefight. The M3E1 also features an interface for intelligent sights, allowing soldiers to program air-bursting rounds to explode above a precise point. Remember that the Carl Gustav's selling point is that it's cheap, simple and brutal on the battlefield. Eventually, it will wear out. So Saab added a device which records how many times